Dr. P here. I want to talk to you about circular motion and centripetal force and centripetal acceleration. So for objects that are moving and rotating around in a circle, let's say I have a ball and it's attached to a string and rotating around this circle in this direction. If this is moving at a constant speed around this circle, that means that the tangential velocity will be constant. A constant tangential velocity also tells us that we would have a constant angular velocity. Remember, because tangential velocity just is the radius multiplied by the angular speed. Okay, so this object is moving around and around and around in a circle. At the point up here at the top, this object will have two forces. If this is a ball on a string, we have two forces. We have the force of gravity that pulls down on it always. And then because there's a string, this object will also have a force of tension. Now, that force of tension will depend on how fast the ball is going, and we're going to talk about that in just a second. We'll see. So remember, the centripetal force is not a force. It's a way of talking about the forces that are in the radial direction. And so the centripetal force is really the sum of all of the forces in the radial direction. And so that idea of radial direction is just like pointed in towards the middle of the circle. So when I look at the ball here, the forces that are acting in the radial direction are the force of tension and the force of gravity. And they're both in the positive radial direction. Positive is towards the center. So whichever way is towards the center is going to be positive, and away from the center will be negative. All right. So you have seen a video deriving a formula for centripetal acceleration. So this acceleration towards the center. So think Newton's second law, F net equals mass times acceleration. We can think of this also as the centripetal force is equal to mass times the centripetal acceleration. Now, we found this equation earlier, the centripetal acceleration. AC is just the tangential velocity squared over the radius of the circle. So how fast is this going, and how big is the circle that it's making? You can also use this velocity tangent is radius times the angular acceleration to come up with the centripetal acceleration in terms of omega, or in terms of the angular speed or angular velocity, as being just omega squared times r is our centripetal acceleration. These two equations for acceleration don't appear on the AP exam sheet, so they're worth memorizing. All right, now that we have this idea of centripetal acceleration, centripetal force, we can say that the centripetal force is the mass times, I'm going to use the tangential velocity one, velocity tangent squared over the radius. This is where the sum of the forces come in. So we can then insert our force of tension and our force of gravity for the centripetal force in this case. Okay, you can probably imagine a scenario where this ball is going around the circle, around the circle, and if it goes slower, it could fall. And so this idea of the ball is moving around the circle, the slower it could fall. So the slower it goes, the smaller the force of tension becomes. So if I wanted to find the minimum velocity that this ball traveling in the circle can have, that is the velocity with which the force of tension becomes zero. So that force of tension decreases. The minimum velocity is when that tangent force is zero. So we can send that to zero. Force of gravity is just mg. So our tangential minimum velocity over the radius, we can then cancel our masses, solve for the tangential velocity, and we get this minimum velocity for a ball going around a circle is the square root of the gravitational field strength times the radius of that circle.